Hello everyone and welcome back to Jenna Voice. So audition season is still very much in full swing, so I have a few more kind of just tips and tricks related videos for audition season. So if you are auditioning and you're looking for more tips, this video might be for you. So today's video I want to make all about organizing your music for an audition. So auditions, as we know, can be pretty stressful and anxiety driven. So every little bit that we can do to prepare before we get to that audition is going to make it just a little bit easier for us. So one of those things you can do is make sure your music is organized to the best of its ability. And by music, I'm referring to the accompanist's music, not your own. And I think it needs to be said that it's really important for you to keep two copies of music that you are working on, one for your own use that you can make all the notes you want to and need to when you're learning a new piece, and a separate copy that has as little written on it as possible for your accompanist. If you're going into an audition and giving an accompanist your music that has your IPA, your notes when you were learning the piece, possible staging notes, like it can just be really, really crowded and difficult for your accompanist to read the notes, and that is their job. And they may be looking at a piece for the first time or a piece that they don't do very often. They're not gonna have time to look through it or practice it. You just need to make it as easy for them as you possibly can. Because if you are traveling for auditions, this is probably someone you haven't worked with, so you want to make your music as clear to them as possible. With having two copies of music, it's important that the accompanist copy or copies is in its very own binder, a binder just for the accompanist music. None of your other music is going to go in there. You are keeping this binder just for them. And along with that, only keep the music that you need for that specific audition in that binder. If you're doing a bunch of auditions, there's a chance you may need to switch up some music or bring more pieces to one audition versus another, and it can be really tempting to just keep it all in that binder. But when you walk into that room to audition, only have the pieces you need for that audition. Because if your accompanist needs to flip through tons and tons of pages of music that they wouldn't even need for that audition, it takes up more time, it looks like you're unorganized. So take out that music you don't need and just put it aside, put it in your own binder, a place that you know you won't lose it. Just keep it separate and only keep what you need in that binder for each audition. All right, now, like I said, with keeping the music as clean as possible, that doesn't mean you cannot make notes on it for your accompanist. In fact, it's better that you do make notes for them. If you are taking breath marks that are not in obvious places where there are rests or places where you just need to take personal liberties as a singer, you should mark that down in your music so that it's clear for your accompanist when you need just a little bit of extra time or when tempos are going to change if it's not already written in the music. Those sorts of things should be written in for them, so you don't need to spend extra time explaining to them what you're gonna do at different parts of the music right before your audition. It's not a bad thing to talk to your accompanist right before you start to sing. For example, if you need to establish your initial tempo, that's great. Take a second to do that. But other than that, things that can be explained by writing them clearly and concisely instead of verbally taking the extra time to verbally explain them and taking time out of your audition, it just looks a lot better. It looks more professional, looks like you know what you're doing. So definitely make notes of what you need to, where you need to in your music. Okay, another thing that I like to do for my accompanists when I'm bringing pieces into auditions is to separate each piece with a divider, a plastic divider. I get the colored ones. You can get any color, it doesn't matter. The colors don't matter. But the point is, it's a lot easier for them to just grab a divider rather than flip page by page by page looking for pieces that the judges have asked you to sing or whatever it is. So that's just one little trick that can save time, make it just a little bit easier for your accompanist. All right, another tip that I have that I've heard from most accompanists that I've encountered is to not put your music into those clear plastic sleeves. And that's like those individual sheets of music. So they're flipping through like little pieces of plastic instead of pieces of paper. I think people fear that their music is going to stick together, which it can, but there are other ways to kind of avoid that and counter that. But putting your music into plastic sleeves is very greatly off-putting to most accompanists. There is always the risk that the light can hit the pages and make it more difficult for them to read it, or the matting can kind of fog, if it's matted, it can fog up the music and make it just a little blurrier. Like, just don't use sleeves. If you print your music on decent quality paper, you're really gonna be fine. Another way that you can avoid your music sticking together is to actually like practice flipping through that music a few times. And I will also kind of dog ear individual sleeves so that's easier for them to grab one page and not risk them grabbing a few pages at a time or whatever. So take that into consideration. Whatever makes it easier for them to turn the pages as quickly as possible, but just don't use the sleeves. Just don't do it. All right, so my last tip for organizing your music is to put your choice in the very front of the binder. Most auditions, you walk in and you choose the first piece that is to be sung. Usually that's the case. And there's just really no reason for you to bury that aria or song in the binder somewhere. Just put it on top, make it the very first piece. There's no reason that your accompanist should be searching for it. So make sure that's on top when you've made the decision of which piece you want to start with, and you'll be off to smooth sailing, shall we say. So those are my tips for organizing your music for an audition. I hope you found this to be helpful. If you have other tips of organizing your music for auditions, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And as always, please subscribe if you've not already and you want to keep up with more videos like this, more tips for singers, more tips for auditions. So, all right, everyone, that's the video for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will talk to you all very soon. Bye.